John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. We'd like to welcome those just tuning in on the show for a live look-in. You're right on time. Fernando Tatis Jr. might be looking at his last opportunity to extend his hitting streak. Well, got to pause on that thought, as that'll do it. Our final score here, 9-5. Ha-Sung Kim digs in now.
The bat, number 7. Ha-Sung Kim.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
2-1 out. Ground ball could be 2. Goes to second for 1, and that's 2. The final here today. So two down. Joey Gallo steps to the plate. He's already homered in this game. And that one is lifted in the air. He's under it. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. Batter will be Fernando Tatis Jr. Golden opportunity right here. Swing and a high fly ball. That one out towards left center field. Way back there. And it one hits the wall. Here comes Machado around third. He's safe. And they clear the bases. And they lead by two.
Such great concentration.
Righty reliever out of the pen, Joel Payens.
And as relievers go, he's not a big strikeout guy. Tries to force weak contact, so command and execution are huge for him.
Into center. Mitchell really on his horse for it. Hauls it in after a long run. Two away. Here's the catcher to hit, Luis Campusano. Pulls that one foul. Two outs and one in scoring position. Swing and a line drive, base hit out into center field. The throw in, it's offline. The run comes in.
Big at bat to pad their lead up to three. That pretty much split.
Yeah. Matt Barnes takes over on the mound.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time,
puts it away for the out.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
That one ripped. Makes the catch, ball game, and the Nationals come in here and finish off a three-game sweep. Next for the Padres, Jackson Merrill. And that's outside. And that's ball one. Some activity in the bullpen for Texas. Jose Leclerc appears to be getting ready for Bruce Bochy.
It's got to feel good. You'll often hear the phrase, short to it, long through it, and that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the left.
Throws the first. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. But they pick up one run on the... Thank you. Okay, all set to go. And we're back. New inning getting started. Now it's Fernando Tatis Jr. And the righty deals. Now swinging. And that's the first out.
Well, he didn't get the call on the mound, the pitch before.
Now batting, designated hitter, Lane Thompson. The third baseman, number 5, Jamie Candelario.
Yeah.
Luis Campusano getting ready to hit. Man at second. Liner caught at second.
It's never fun going back to the dugout after hitting a line drive that finds a glove, but you will get.
Fernando Tatis Jr. to hit here.
Fernando Tatis Jr.
Now you get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Tatis waits. Pitch misses there. And now three balls and a strike. There's a swing and a drive. Slams into the wall and hangs on.
Man, Boog, I love watching. This was a tightly played game, got a little of everything.
Yeah.